So the expectation level very high in Muncie, Indiana with the Ball State Cardinals. Now let's swing right back here into the state of Michigan, where Ron English starts his fifth year as the head coach of the Eastern Michigan Eagles. 2011 MAC Coach of the Year. It all begins at home at Reinierson Stadium against Howard on August 31st, and you'll see that right here on the ESPN family of networks. We say hello to Ron English. Always good to see this dapper gentleman.
How you
gentleman.
Guys doing?
Yeah, we're great. Good. He's just telling us he's been on the AAU basketball trail with
been
his
on the
son.
Circuit. Been on the circuit.
Yeah, okay, but now it's time for the helmets and the pads to come
That's right.
on for your Eagles. As last season ended, and we know it wasn't in the fashion that 2011 was,
sure,
as we mentioned,
sure.
You were coach of the year. What was the Ron English message to his Eastern Michigan football team about what he needed from them going into 2013?
Well, it's interesting because, you know, I knew going in we had a young team, and I was hoping that we would develop a little bit faster than we did. But the message was really psychological. I mean, I thought we went in last year, and you guys have done this a long time, with a team that had some success and didn't realize how hard it is to maintain that and how hard it is to win football games. And at any level, I don't care what team you're coaching, it's hard to win football games.
Ron, the big news out of Ypsilanti this year, of course, is you bring in Stan Parrish now.
Who?
We've heard of that
Our buddy?
Guy. As offensive coordinator, and in my opinion, just as big a news, you're now the defensive coordinator.
I am.
Yeah, tell me your philosophy there and how we're doing with all that transition.
Well, with Stan, you know what you're going to get. He's
sure
done
good.
It a long time. He's very successful. But I will tell you what really surprised me about Stan is, his flexibility. You know, because some guys can coach a long time and develop a system and be married to that, and he is not, he's proven not to be that way. He's been very flexible. I think he's going to use his weapons. And what I was most excited about is coaching against him every day, because I coached against him at Michigan, coached against him at Eastern, and know that he can do some things to make you uncomfortable, and he can do some things to kind of get you out of some stuff that you want to run. And so, speaking about Stan, I mean, I think that's impressive. But I'm telling you, it's changed my life going back and coaching defense. It really has changed I'm just happy every day. I love developing players. I love I'd be a guy who, if you told me to coach one guy and get him better, I'd be happy as a lark doing that. And so now being back over there and being able to develop these guys, and I think you develop a player and to first understanding what it takes to be successful, and in that process, and then gain some confidence. I coach some confidence into them. So hopefully I can still do those things. But I say this all the time. We'll see if I'm any good. We'll see if I'm any good, because
okay.
The guys in this league are good.
Yeah. Well, yeah, that's where I was going to go next, because the gaudy offensive numbers in this league
that's exactly
are something
right.
that you're going to have to deal with now.
Yes, right.
As the DC every week. But back to Coach Parrish. So I'm envisioning now you got him in the laboratory with Tyler Benz, who started 10 football games for you.
Yeah.
So what's being cooked up in the laboratory, and how good do you feel about Tyler in working with Stan and his ability to improve?
I think that Stan, as any good football coach does, teaches him what is a quarterback first. And it's not just taking a snap and throwing the ball, but there's a bunch more that goes into it. And that's what I've seen most. In terms of Tyler's growth. I think we know that he can throw the football, he's a big kid and all those things, but now he got to learn how to be a quarterback. And if there's anybody who can teach you how to be a quarterback, obviously Stan, he's coached, I don't even need to go into the Bradys and all those people that he's coached, and Johnson at Tampa and all those people.
Yep.
And the kid he had at Ball State, when we
Keith
played,
no. Page.
Nate Davis.
Nate Davis.
Oh, Nate Davis before that. You're right, yeah.
Now, my introduction to Nate Davis was this. This is the truth. We played Ball State at Michigan, and we had a really good defense. And so I was one of those guys who wanted to play everybody. And so so I said, okay, after the first two series of the third quarter, I'm going to put all my backups in. Mm-hmm. So I did, okay. I swear, probably the first play. Bam! 50-yard touchdown.
Yep.
This was 2006.
2006.
When you wound up, Michigan wound up number two in the nation.
Yes.
You were undefeated.
Yes.
Yeah.
We end up a second series. Bam! Touchdown. So now I got to put the starters back in. Well, now he's got us on the run. We have to hold on to win the game. I think we wanted something like 28-20. Mm-hmm. So I go in the locker room. Lloyd's like, if you ever do that again, you're fired. Nate Davis. Yeah. I mean, that kid, yeah. He took some hits. He made great decisions, and he delivered the football, and he was a true freshman.
Yeah, right, exactly.
Ryan, now the word I'm getting out of Ypsilanti is going to be a lot more aggressive on defense. That's your personality.
Well,
I know you. A lot of press coverage.
Well,
I mean, talk to me.
We'll see what happens. We'll see. We'll see what happens, but we do have speed. And I think when you have some speed on the edges, I mean, you can do a lot of things. And so I like our speed. I like our speed as a team. We have not had, in fact, to be frank, we have as much speed as any team I've been around. Now, how that translates into playing, we'll see, but because you got to play fast. And
yep.
To do that, you have to know what you're doing, and you have to have confidence. But I do like our speed.
Well, let's stay with defense, because a young man that caught our eye, the Kalonji Kashama, is that Elaine Kashama's? Is that a relative? Is that a brother?
That's a brother, believe
you
it
You
or
had Elaine when you were D.C. at Michigan,
we had Elaine.
Correct? Yes.
We had Elaine, and Elaine was one of those guys. You know, he's 6'5", 275-pound guy, and I think he ran in the 4-5 for the Pro Scouts.
Okay.
Early draft pick and a good football player.
Great bloodlines in the family.
Good bloodlines.
Yeah.
Well, one played at Western, okay, to one played at Michigan, and I'm sure I'm forgetting another one where he played, and then we have Cash. So, you know, what they are is great kids with great demeanors, really smart, great family. And so I think it's his time to, you know, he's been hurt really the better part of the last 2 years. And so now he's been able to really lift all summer and get stronger. And so I'm excited for him to be healthy and to have a great senior year.
11 true freshmen you played last year.
Yep.
I believe me, I know how painful that can be at times. But the development of those kids, they hit good spring and ready to go.
And depth.
Yep.
And depth. So, you know, yeah, we played a lot of true freshmen, but lost in that fact is, you know, we had some second-year men who played. So, in other words, really a young football team. So now it's like one of the young corners said to me, now I know what to expect when I go out there. So what happens is they train a little bit differently, they pay attention a little bit differently, right. And they become exponentially better. So that's really what I expect. But, yeah, we played a lot of young players, developed some depth, and we'll see how that translates.
Should be a lot of fun in Ypsilanti, Michigan. It all starts.
Yeah,
the rock.
Yeah.
All right, good
I'm
luck.
Excited. Thank you, guys.
Stay excited.
Appreciate it. Yep.
We look forward to seeing you during the season.
Thank you.
Here on the ESPN Family
Thank
Networks.
You.
Ron English, the head football coach. 2011 MAC Coach of the Year. You know he'd like to duplicate that coming up in 2013. Appreciate it, Ron.
Take care,
Thank
guys.
You, Ron.
Thank you.